Alright, as you can see, I've been roped in to do this as well. And they're not going to stop for me, so we actually have to talk while we actually do this exercise. It's not easy. But I've been told that they can actually talk while we do this. Oh, thank you so much. Thank you so much. Oh, hold on. Okay, so I'm half dead now officially, and I don't think I can move anymore. I probably need a wheelchair after this. Thanks to Atilia and Auntie Samia. Thank you so much.
No problem. Anytime.
Inclusion in my life. Such a wonder.
You'll feel better tomorrow.
Yeah.
You sleep well tonight.
Oh, okay. This is what she's been telling you all this while, is it?
Yes.
Okay. All right. I'll take your word for it. Now, okay. Let's talk a little bit more about your work. You know, how do I put this? Your mom is legendary. I mean, you've been known since the 70s. And
yeah.
Even until now, you turn on radio and your songs are still on air.
And you didn't have many albums, did you?
Yeah.
You had only...
Well, it doesn't, you know, it's
yes.
not about
EPs
quantity. It's about quality. It's not about quality. It's about quantity now.
It's not about quantity.
It's about quality.
Yeah,
it is. But you've had, I mean, you've never really gone away. You've had your albums, and then you've had your singles out on radio, and you still do shows until today.
Yes,
so
yes.
That's what you call staying power.
Mm.
Now, do you feel as if you are Atilia Salamia Hassan's daughter, or do you feel like you have emerged?
I will always be Salamia Hassan's daughter.
I mean, professionally.
Yeah, even before, whenever I wanted to do a show or anything, people would introduce me as Salamia Hassan's daughter. And now now the pattern has changed.
Yes.
She's now Atilia's mom.
Atilia's mom.
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
But it doesn't really matter to us because I'm very proud to be Salamia Hassan's daughter, and I don't use it as like people say that I use my mom's name, or I've never done that. So I'm just proud to be her daughter, and I will always be Salamia Hassan's daughter. So it doesn't really matter what people call me, right?
Okay. So I suppose.
And I'm proud to be.
I was going to say the reversal role should be. You know, are you? How do you feel when people say, "Oh, she's Atilia's mom"?
Yeah, the young people, the teenagers. They don't know Salamia Hassan. They don't even know how Salamia Hassan looks like, but they know Salamia Hassan songs. Apparently they do. And when I perform in clubs, and I will introduce myself, I said, I am Salamia Hassan, and also known as Atilia's mom. Then they goes, wow, oh, that's the mom, you know. So I am very proud to have a daughter like this, like Atilia, and you know, it's a very good feeling to see your daughter on stage with you performing, and we do perform together a lot.
Yeah, tell me a little bit about, you know, this working together. You know, what have you guys done together?
We do a lot of corporate shows together. Because sometimes all the older generation, they would prefer to listen to Salamia, and the younger ones, they would want to listen to me. So it's actually a good combo, it's a good combination.
Yeah, because you address all the markets.
So we do a lot of that, and since we do a lot of that, we have a lot of rehearsals, a lot of sound checks, so that's how we spend time together. Yeah.
And we both are serious workers, and my daughter is very serious with her job, and so am I. So we're very professional, and I'm very glad that my daughter has learned a lot from me for not being late for anything and right on the dot. And when it comes to work, we work.
Mm-hmm.
And for me, if we're supposed to be there at 8 o'clock. I'm already there before 8, and mm-hmm. so is my daughter, on time. And we don't like anyone who is late and all this and that, but mm-hmm. we tolerate, but it's okay as long as we are not late, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because she's always been a singer. That's her job since her first job until now, so mm-hmm. she takes it very seriously. There was once when we were supposed to sing outdoor and it was raining, and I was so happy and I said, yay, we don't have to sing, it's mm-hmm. raining. And she got really angry. She said, no, we are paid to sing, we sing, it doesn't matter whether it rains or not. So that's how professional she is. She's very disciplined when it comes to timing, more disciplined than I am. Mm-hmm. disciplined when it comes to timing, learning her songs. She will lock herself in a room with her MP3 player, and she will learn her songs, and she will remember the lyrics, and whatever the request, she will learn. Mm-hmm. And that I don't really see in a lot of new artists nowadays. So I mm-hmm. try to learn that from her, mm-hmm. because I don't get a lot of good influences like that around me nowadays.
Yeah,
because
yeah,
people
yeah.
are like, it's well, okay, just put your lyrics in front of you, and yeah. it doesn't matter. But for her, that is really wrong to have lyrics in front of you when you sing, because yeah. that's your job. People right. pay you to do that. So take some time to learn a song.
Right, I see. Well, let's talk a little bit about style. Jazz is the name of the game here.
Yeah.
You're so soulful when you sing. YouTube you and, you know, all this, you know, soulful tunes come out. You're soulful to begin with. And that soulfulness has also spilled onto Ottilia. So is this a style that you guys agreed upon, or it's just something that you're comfortable with?
Yeah, I'm comfortable with it because when I start,
we sing from the heart.
Yeah, we sing from the heart. Whatever songs, you know. When people label me as a jazz singer, I don't think I am. It's just that I work in clubs and they prefer me to sing jazz songs, so mm-hmm. I do sing jazz. And if people request me to sing dandut for any show, I still learn and do dandut, you know. Mm-hmm. But if you ask me to choose, I rather do jazz.
You'd rather do jazz?
Yes, yeah.
Right, and is it the same for you?
For me, I listen to a lot of music. I listen to even metal. Mm-hmm. But when it comes to singing, I just feel that I express myself better in jazz, and my voice is probably sesuai with jazz, because I'm not an acrobatic singer. I don't mm-hmm. have a lot of frills.
Same here.
I don't do a lot of soulful R&B twists, mm-hmm. Mariah Carey, whatever. I sing, and when I sing, I try to tell a story through my songs. Mm-hmm. And usually, the melody jadi macam very subtle and very me, I think.
It's very you. Okay.
Yeah.
So who are amongst some of the singers that you both look up to?
Ooh, we love, she loves The Carpenters.
The Carpenters, yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's what you grew up with, isn't it?
Yeah, Billie Holiday. Yeah.
Billie Holiday. And
Ella Fitzgerald. But I listen to a lot of new stuff, like a lot of acid jazz. Mm-hmm. I love Sheila Majid. I love Khadija Ibrahim. I love Sade. Mm-hmm. And yeah, we are planning to watch Sade in US end of August. Hopefully that happens.
Ooh. Yeah.
Oh, okay. So that's the together time.
Yeah.
That,
yeah.
That's in the works happening soon. Okay, we have to go for another short break right now, and I refuse to sit on this mat or ask me in anymore after this. So we're gonna go out and get some fresh air
and have some nasi lemak.
No more nasi lemak. Stay with us, and in person we have more questions for Ottilia and also Aunty Salamiah. Stay with us.